Welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to see how to pass a list of values into a variable to a stored procedure. So we will do that in, let's say, 4 steps. So the very first one is just to create a sample table. So I just drop it if it exists already in my database. I execute the create table statement. As you can see, we have an identity for the customer ID. I insert 5 lines of data using this insert statement. And I check the content. So what you have just done is the very preliminary step, let's say. And now we'll go through the 3 steps to create a table type, create the stored procedure, and how to call the stored procedure. Let's start with the first one. So in this first step, we create a table type, what we also called a user-defined data type. We have a create statement, it's create type. You name the table type, here it's integer list type, and you say as table. So it will be created as a table type. So be aware that it's not creating a table here, it's creating a table type. Think about it as a model of a table, as a specific variable type. We have 1 column, which is number, and it's an integer type. So I create the table type. Once you create the table type, you can go into your database under programmability and under types, and you can check the table types here. Here you have user defined table type. So I refresh it, and it is here. So it's definitely not a table because the table contain data, but this will be our model for the rest of this tutorial. In step 2, we need to create a stored procedure that accepts this table type as an input and use it in the code. You just create a normal stored procedure, start by create procedure, you name it. So here it's select customers by IDs. And here is the difference, is that we have a parameter called customer IDs, but its type is not envarchar or integer or something like that. It's the data type that we created in the previous step. And it is a read-only. So this is the little subtlety in this tutorial. And then you can use it inside your stored procedure. So it's just a simple select. We only have an additional filter where customer ID in select number, which will contain in our customer IDs later, from customer IDs. We create the procedure. So in step 3, we need to declare a variable, which is a table variable because it is using our integer list type. We insert a few values into this variable. Here it's very manual because it's using an insert into, but we'll see after this a different way to do it, more repeatable, and that can be more automated using variables. And then you simply call the stored procedure by passing the variable to it. And that's it. And here, as you can see, we filtered our table with 1, 2, 3 customer IDs that we had here. This is a simple way to pass a list of values, let's say as a column, and not having to create multiple variables to pass this parameter to a stored procedure. There is a second way of inserting values into the table without having to do, let's say, manual insert. You can do it like that using the string split function. You declare your variable, you insert into it, but this time you use the string split. So whatever, how many values are there, you will have just one variable. You can store this in simply one variable. So the difference is that the string split will use the separator to transform this into a column. Execute it like that. You have all in one column, and you don't have to perform multiple insert intos to add different customer IDs. And that's it for this short tutorial. If you find our content helpful, please subscribe and hit the like button. It really helps us.